Isaiah chapter 29, verse 13.
Read.
Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth,
they do draw near the Most High with your mouth. That means you talk a good one. I just told you in the streets it says walk the walk and talk the talk. That's the that's what street people say, right? So how you gonna walk the walk and talk the talk when it comes to God? How you gonna do that?
Me? And with their lips do honor me.
And with your lips shall honor him. Talking a good one. I love the Most High. I do anything for him. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. You playing games with the Most High.
Read. But have removed their heart far from me.
Your mind. You have removed your mind far. Far from the Most High.
Read. And their fear toward me is taught by the precept of men.
So y'all fear God. Why? Because Donald Trump says in God we trust. That's the precepts of men. Because he don't even fear God. He think he above God. According to Obadiah, they think they above God. Who gonna bring me down to the ground? That's what it says, right? That's what they think. I'm the most powerful man in the world. That's what he thinking when he go to bed at night. When he sleep with his stripper wife he got. That's what he thinking. He thinking he the most, he thinking he above the Most High. Read.
That's it. Verse 14. Therefore, behold, I will proceed to do a marvelous work.
So the Most High is going to proceed to do a marvelous work, read.
Among this people.
Among this people.
Come on now. Even a marvelous work and a wonder.
A marvelous work and a wonder. You people are the marvelous works and wonders when you come back to these Lord's statutes and commandments, man.
Read. For the wisdom of their wise men shall perish.
The wisdom of their wise men shall perish.
That's right.
And the understanding of their prudent men shall be hid.
And the understanding of their prudent men shall be hid. In other words, stop playing games with the Most High, man. Stop trying to give him lip service. Stop trying to think you could trick the Most High. You can't trick him, man. He's beyond your understanding. I don't care how smart you think he is. Let me get Proverbs 11 and 28. You can't trick the Most High. You have to submit. The Bible is not, you got to conform to what the Bible is saying. The Bible does not have to conform to how you think you should live. You people are sleeping out here. You need to wake up. You people are crazy. You're not understanding what's going on out here, man. Y'all playing games with the Most High. You keep playing games. He's going to keep unleashing these pestilence. And these tornadoes and hurricanes and whirlwinds and earthquakes. Those are signs from the Most High. You know your nationality according to the Bible, my brother?
Nah, but I'm part of the 13 Israelites.
What 13 Israelites is that? So do you see your father on this side? Where your father's from on this side of the world? So you will be a Puerto Rican according to what the white man would call you. So your father's of what they call Ephraim. So you, my brother, are a child of the Most High. You are an Israelite from the tribe of Ephraim. I don't want to hear you calling yourself Puerto Rican no more. Because that's a byword. That's not your nationality that God gave you. Drop that. Let me get the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28. That's a byword. What's that, 46? That's a byword in the proverb. That's not your real nationality. That's something that the colonialists and the conquerors came, the conquest of the conquistadors when they came to your land. They came and told you, oh, this is a rich port, because that's what Puerto Rican means, right? Rich port. You're not a rich port, my brother. You know what I mean? You're a tribe, you're from the tribe of Ephraim. Your forefather was Joseph. Joseph had two sons, Ephraim and Manasseh. Notice how the Cubans got the same flag as y'all, right? It's just reverse, like opposite.
But it's the same thing. Y'all brothers from the same father, Joseph. Read. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 37.
Read.
And thou shalt become an astonishment.
An astonishment. That means a spectacle. Read.
A proverb.
A proverb. You ever want to have something from a Puerto Rican or a black, you put it in the book. That's a proverb. It's like a slick, wise saying. Read.
And a byword among all nations whither the Lord shall lead thee.
A byword. A byword is Puerto Rican, Negro, Dominican, Jamaican, Haitian. Those are proverbs. Those are bywords. That's not your God-given nationality. When you read the Bible, you don't read none of that in the Bible. You will read the tribe of Ephraim, no? You will read the tribe of Manasseh, the tribe of Simeon, the tribe of Gad. You understand? We descend from tribes. You know what I mean? We don't descend. We descend from the nationality of man. His name is Jacob. His name later was changed to Israel when he wrestled the angel. You got a flyer, my brother?
Flyer?
A flyer. One of them flyers. He gave you one flyers? Give him a flyer, please. Look and read that, King. You understand? Because we are kings and priests on this earth. We fallen and we got to take back our rightful position. You understand? Go to 49 for me. 49.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 49. The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far.
Wait, so start right there. So the nation that came against the tribe of Ephraim from afar was Christopher Columbus, right? And the conquest of the conquistadors. They came from afar. When they came there, y'all wasn't speaking Spanish. Y'all wasn't speaking Puerto Rican. Y'all was speaking Hebrew. You understand? You wasn't speaking the language you speak now. Y'all was taught that from them. The Spaniards, when they came over there, the conquest of the conquistadors in 1492. You follow? See, this Bible is not a religious book. This is a history book. This is a history book, right? This book right here shows us who we are. This is not a religion. Nowhere in this book does God says be a Catholic. Be into Roman Catholicism. You understand? When he came off the Mount Sinai, he came down with laws, statutes, and commandments for us to follow. He didn't come down here and say, oh yeah, be a Mormon, be a Jehovah's Witness. He didn't say that. That's nowhere in the Bible. So our people are destroyed. Let me get Hosea 4:6. Our people are destroyed. They destroyed because they don't know who they are or is. Right? They don't know who you don't know who you are. That's why when I asked you who you was, you said, oh, I'm Puerto Rican. Right? The other brother I asked a few minutes ago, he said he's from the West Indies. Right? That's just a colonizer's term for calling you like that a slave. He's from the tribe of Benjamin, that's correct. I'm from the tribe of Judah. He's from the tribe of Benjamin as well. He's from the tribe of Benjamin. You understand what I'm saying? We don't call ourselves black. Or Puerto Rican or Hispanic. We don't call ourselves that because that's not what we are. That's not what we are. We are a nation of kings and priests. Read that for me.
The book of Hosea chapter 4 verse 6.
Read.
My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
See, our people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. The knowledge of these scriptures, we don't know them. We call ourselves everything under the sun but what God calls us. Read.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee.
So he said, because we reject knowledge, the knowledge of who we are, who we is as a people, as a nation. We're supposed to gather ourselves together. We're supposed to be with one another. We're not supposed to be running around here hanging on to what the white man telling us to do and all of that nonsense. That's a game. We ain't got time to be playing no games with God, because he ain't playing no games with us. You see, we were in slavery, right?
Because seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of thy power, I will also forget thy children.
So just because we forgot the law of our power, the law of our power is the law, statutes, and commandments that God gave us. He didn't give us religion.